Hello folks, so far we have covered the basics in elementary set theory. We've learned what sets are, how to define or express them, then the different operations that can be performed on sets. We've also learned about the subsets, supersets, and power sets. Now it's time to focus our attention on Venn diagrams. In order to understand the role of Venn diagrams in the study of set theory, one only needs to think of the role of maps in geography or of diagrams in biology. Or for that matter, the role of infographics in the presentation of information today. Simply put, Venn diagrams are diagrams with the help of which we represent different sets and the relationships between them pictorially. Let's look at a few Venn diagrams to see what they are, what they look like, and how they work. Say we have a universal set whose elements are natural numbers from 1 to 9, and we have another set which has elements 1, 2, 5, and 7. So, how do we represent this information using Venn diagrams? Well, we represent a universal set using a rectangular region. So we draw a rectangle and put the elements of the universal set inside the boundary of the rectangle. Other sets are generally represented using circles. In our case, there's a universal set with only one subset, set A. So our Venn diagram needs a rectangle and a circle. But we also need to show the relationship between the two sets. That A is a subset of U. How do we do that? Well, when we say A is a subset of U, we essentially mean that everything that is contained in A is also contained in U. In other words, whatever is inside the circle is also present inside the rectangle. So in order to express this fact, we put the circle inside the rectangle. Now let us populate the regions with the elements. We begin with the innermost regions and move outwards. This helps us prevent redundancy or multiple listings of elements. Here, the innermost region is the region of the set A. So we give A its elements. See, we put the elements of A inside the circle which represents the set A. And now the universal set represented by the rectangular region. This region already contains the region of set A. And therefore, it already contains the elements that set A has. So we need to add only the remaining ones, 3, 4, 6, 8, and 9. As you can see, we put these elements outside the circle because these elements are not contained in the set A. And the circle will contain only those elements which do belong to set A. And that completes this Venn diagram. Easy, right? Now let us change this problem a little bit. Let's bring one more set in the picture. We now have another set B with elements 8 and 9. Like any other set, this will also be a subset of the universal set. And so the circle representing B will also lie within the rectangle. And as in the previous example, we fill the innermost regions first. The regions of A and B. And then whatever remains, we put in the outer region of the rectangle. You can see here. A, then B, and now the rest of the rectangle. So this is how our Venn diagram should look like. Easy again. One important thing to note here is that if you look at A and B, there's nothing in common between the two sets. Not even one element. And this is clearly visible in the Venn diagram too. The circular regions A and B do not intersect. They do not have any overlap. That is, there is no region that is common to both. But what happens if there are some elements common to the two sets? That and more in the next episode. Thank you for watching.